So our next panel is called Dealing with Military Shock Trauma and Ethics of Service Delivery. I'm excited it's coming right after the peer-to-peer support, because imagine yourself waking up in a hospital after being injured at the front line, and the last thing you remember is an evacuation from the front lines by your peers. You wake up and you have those doctors above your head and you have no idea where you are. They speak the same language, you know that the enemy speaks the same language as you, you might be on the other side, and nobody tells you what is actually happening. You ask doctors the questions, what is going on with my body, what is going on, what are you giving me, where am I? And for 2 days, they tell you nothing. They're keeping complete silence, you don't have a phone number to call your parents, you cannot reach out, and you have no idea what is going on with your body. In 2 days, Pavel, whose story this is, and he is also part of our organization, got a phone from a volunteer volunteering at the hospital, and he could call his father, and the father was the first person to tell him actually what happened, what is going on with his body, what treatment is he receiving, and what the process will look like. But for 2 days, he was in complete silence from all the service providers around him. Unfortunately, this situation is quite common in Ukraine. We have a quite Sovietic system of service providing, and we are trying our best to change it on the local level. But in that mass, this is how it looks. On the psychological level, on the medical level, on the way we communicate with the veteran through the governmental entities. And so via this next panel, I want to expand on the topic how the services have to be provided. What are the rules of communication in service providers? Let me introduce the panel. So Heidi Marcher is the board member of Bodynamic International, an institute providing services and training in body-oriented therapy. He's the third generation of Bodynamic, and he'll tell more about the system itself. Tatiana Sirenko is a representative of the Bluebird NGO. She works with traumatized by violence, sexual violence, war traumas. She provides group and individual therapy for those people who experience torture, and also work with veterans in a group format and a personal therapy. Dylan Tiet, we've heard from him yesterday, and it was an amazing story about the trip to Donbas. He's the executive director of the Bastion Community of Resilience, and I'm very happy to have you at this panel today to expand on the topic a bit more. We had a chance to speak about after the panel yesterday as well. And Olga Schwess is a military psychologist who's been working with the military for the past 4 years. She's graduated the university in 2014 from the National Aviation University, and since then she's been working with the veterans and with the soldiers on the front lines. She has been serving herself in the military and will tell her story of how it is to incorporate into a governmental structure in Ukraine from the civilian society. Okay, so starting it from here, Heidi, I pass it to you.